guess I'll take whatever color you win because...
You take what you get, you ungrateful shit.
Well, the one with the dollar sign on. Oh, blue! A twofer! Hold on! Hold it! No!
Good seat.
For those of you that don't know, this past weekend I was at a conference. I had planned to speak on some culture issues in video games and movies. But kind of more importantly to me, I got to hang out with some e-friends, some internet foins, and spend some time playing video games and playing Magic the Gathering. I played many video games with Mr. Dankula. A lot of you don't know, he's actually my dad, and not a great one. You know, I hardly ever see him, and, you know, I think we had a chance to spend some real quality time at Dave & Buster's playing arcade games. But, you know, it didn't take long for the meanness to start.
You take what you get, you ungrateful shit.
Now, what you don't see in that footage is the reflection of my face where a single tear slid down my face. I quickly rubbed it away, and Mr. Dank was able to eventually defeat the win every single time claw machine. What do you, I want an orange one.
An orange one, right.
There's one that looks kind of like a dog. Don't let me down, Dad.
I think that's a dog and a fox or some shit.
I like it. Oh.
Why is it dog? You didn't get any shit. Fuck you.
But it's play till you win, you know. You know what? The pile's too low. Probably have to get something from in the back there.
Yeah.
Because it only drops down so far. I guess I'll take whatever color you win because...
You take what you get, you ungrateful shit.
Well, the one with the dollar sign on. Oh, blue! A twofer! Hold on! Hold it! No!
Good seat. Fuck. I've been robbed. I've just been robbed. I'm going up there.
Oh, yeah, up top there. That makes sense. The blue one. Looks good. Oh, that's a good grab. That's a trifecta grab in my industry. What's your prize? Aww. Thank you. Thanks, Dad. Now, after I got my toy, it was time for Dank to go play. And what kind of game do you think he picked? Do you think he wanted to play some Mario Kart or maybe some Kung Fu Panda or some Skee Ball, something wholesome, maybe some Space Invaders or some Pac-Man? You know, I figured he'd want to play some wholesome entertainment. But he chose House of the Dead.
Bro, no, fuck off. What are you doing?
So what's your position on violent video games?
I'm just pretending this is a school.
Truly shocking admission from my Mr. Dank. It was bone-chilling the way that he was so clear and transparent in his interpretation of this video game. Thankfully, the BBC was there covering his speech, so I have given this footage to them. Well, no, of course I didn't do that. Man, you can feel the saw in your ass.
Fucking hell.
Now, this version of House of the Dead had a little rumble seat and also had little puffs of air in your face. And it was curious that Dankula was so enthused about the rumble in the seat. I mean, I don't want to jump to conclusions here, but I'm just going to go ahead and say that he was not uncomfortable at any point. In fact, he seemed to seek out the enemies that caused this to happen.
I'm worried that if someone's going to attempt to, that's like the Sam Hyde meme.
Definitely don't do that, anybody.
No, definitely don't. I don't want to get blamed for a mass shooting.
Is that Slash?
What the fuck is that?
Now I'm going to leave the rest of his House of the Dead footage from Dave and Buster's for him to upload on his own channel when he gets around to it as he's traveling around the country. Now you may be wondering, what happened to that rubber duck? That duck that Dad gave me? Well, you know, his wife sent me wonderful treats and tablet, which was delicious Sue Hulk, Common, a current off guest on The Incredible Salt Mine, sent me a wonderful gift, which was really tasty. All I had left to remember Dank by was this blue rubber duck, which I'll show you at the end of this video what happened to. But overall, I'd have to say, I don't think that I'm a conference guy going forward. It's not that there was anything weird about the conference or anything upsetting. It was more like, the whole idea of people like paying money to hear me speak is really awkward. I'm much more comfortable just in kind of an open setting. That isn't to like knock on anyone else. It's just weird for me, to kind of get into the mood. I mean, I was hanging out with Dank, who enjoyed his whiskeys quite a bit on a Thursday evening. I brought him a bottle that I hope he enjoyed. And I should have probably bought something for Sue. And now that I'm thinking of it live as I'm recording this, this was a horrible mistake. But today I missed out on going to the range with him, but it looks like he had a lot of fun. And overall, I had a lot of fun meeting a bunch of people at this conference. I had a lot of fun hanging out with Dank as much as my foot would allow. I had some foot problems all weekend, and that was not only kind of a bummer for just me getting around, but it also was kind of just deflating, and it kind of made me crabby. And so, overall, though, it was good. I got to see some good panels on some men's issues that were interesting. Some speakers from all backgrounds. I got to meet some other YouTubers whose channels that I haven't heard of before but are now on my watch list. I got to play Magic the Gathering with Sargon. We did a little Magic pre-release event. I also played Magic with Dankula, and we only played two games, but I imagine he was busy being a superstar and he spent most of his time just trying to meet everybody. And I definitely understand that. So, you know, if you end up with a chance to meet the guy, you know, I'll tell you this, he's definitely shorter than you would expect, but very, very nice guy. He's exactly how you might expect him to be in real life. Just kind, has an infectious laugh. And I had a great time hanging out with him and a great time hanging out with Carl, although I didn't see him as much. And everyone at the conference, I had a good time hanging out with them. And as for the Minds event that's going to be happening in Philadelphia, I'm thinking about going to that. So if you're going to that, I know there'll be like a Roaming Millennial, Shoe on Head, Dank will be there. I'm hoping that I'm all healed up in time for that, and then I can take another swing at hanging out. Definitely want to play some more Claw Machine with Dank, and I want to play some more Magic, and I want to hang out with everyone else. But, rest in pepperonis, my little blue duck, as he's been lost forever, just like my father's love.
Of Dankula on Monday, and it's gonna have ads in it. It's gonna be awesome. He cost it. God damn it.
I can't even find
God
my
damn it.
Oh my God.
Now you could see the way that he treats me. It was shockingly in front of everybody. You know, a guy can't just have a vodka tonic without being ridiculed endlessly by the evil man known as Dank. But I want to leave you all with just some good vibes. You asked for some positive vibes. Well, this whole weekend was the glue that kind of kept everybody together was video games and it was Magic the Gathering. It is a common thread between a lot of people. I even talked to a musician that was there and he was talking about, man, I really should learn Magic because it seems like so many of you guys, like Aiden Paladin was there too. So many of you all play Magic and it's like a good way to kind of meet people and get along with them. And whether it's Magic the Gathering or it's any particular video game or it's just kind of cheesy redemption games at Dave and Buster's, video games have the ability to bring everyone together. And for that brief time, you know, people's belief systems and things like that, they just don't matter. And I think it's important that in life you make time. A lot of people gave me the business for playing Magic the Gathering and they were right to do so. But it's also nice to just once in a while kind of put the swords down and enjoy a good video game with friends or a board game or a tabletop game and then refresh your mind and go into things feeling good. I hope you enjoyed this brief look into it. I didn't want to take a lot of footage because that's always weird, like kind of getting content out of your friends. I didn't really want to, I don't know. I just weird about that. But hope you enjoyed this. And we'll be back with probably a fifth video a little bit later. Talk to you again real soon. Awkward ending.